I figured this whole quarantine situation was a good time to finally get into game development. I tried it before, but I always gave up on it for some reason. So I already had Unity installed and knew some C sharp and started to retry to get into it. But it quickly became obvious to me that it was just too much. Unity felt like something I could never get into because there was just so much stuff going on. Same for C sharp as a programming language in general. So I already played with it before to give up once again. But then I stumbled on YouTube upon Godot, this other engine, and I figured it might be worth to try it out. And what shall I say? It seemed to work. So after now 1.5 weeks of learning Godot and programming with it, I figured it would be a good idea to, or I figured it would be a good idea to start a YouTube channel because I wanted to, and really share my at best my entire learning process in becoming a game dev with you. And you might have already have noticed I'm not very good at this whole recording stuff yet, but I hope it will better itself. I'm pretty sure, I'm confident I will get used to this so I don't have to stumble into the microphone all day. Yeah, let's get started. So how I pretty much teach myself and how I think it's most the best approach pretty much to learning Godot is that I, yeah, of course, downloaded the engine. That's I'm sure I don't have to tell you that. Although I have the Steam version because it updates automatically, and I don't know if the normal client does that, and I don't want to check for updates all the time. Although most of the time, programs like this actually have an auto-updater. Well, I explored this website a little bit on those tabs and finally stumbled upon the Godot docs. And I think this is really the best place to actually get into Godot. You can, of course, always use YouTube tutorials, although I figured out they were pretty case-specific. We will come to their use later. That I think really to get maybe not the bare basics, but the basics of GDScript, the programming language, and Godot as an engine itself. I think for that the Godot docs are actually the best place, because there's this step-by-step manual to get into game development in general, which I figured is pretty good, as well as this pretty specific scripting tutorial that teaches you all about how GDScript works. And it's really not complicated. It's something you can read this entire text in an afternoon. At this point, it probably seems a lot to you, and it is if you never did any kind of programming at all. But it's just something you should do, in my opinion. It's a really effective way to get into this whole thing. Although I think a lot of young people, especially in this time, and I say this even though I'm pretty young myself, a lot of younger people don't like reading, and I think that shouldn't stop you. You should really give this a try and read this thing. And you don't even have to read everything if you already know a lot about, or even a little bit about programming, because it's basically most of this page is just what is here in this table, but explained in more detail. So you probably, if you already did some programming at some point, you know what if, elif, else, for a while, and so on each do. The only thing you then would have to read in this thing would be the signals, probably, because I haven't heard of them before, for sure. Oh, maybe this export thing was really just not that many things. And once you read this, you probably know pretty much everything you need to know about GDScript as a scripting language, and then you can really go ahead and do the step-by-step manual, which then teaches you about the UI and everything. And for this part, I really think you can also use a YouTube tutorial. I think there are great YouTube tutorials for this. Although I prefer to use this documentary to get into the layout. And after the point where you solved this this part, this your first game step, I think, at least I was, I figured myself to be pretty confident to actually make a game myself. And I did at first something small, pretty much an, I can show it to you, an adventure, I choose here an adventure engine mostly. So this is this project here. If I started, you can see there's not much to it, but you can start a new game. Click on options and there's a menu. That's pretty much it, but the thing is that I did this so far, so there was no, there would not be any further programming necessary to do the, to create a game with this. You just would have to write the correct correct text files. And yeah, this is pretty simple project, and I soon got onto my next project, Keller of Doom. It's a roguelike, and I did some parts of the, this. It's really basic at the moment. You can walk around, kill slimes. There's a random level generator, and that's pretty much it so far. Although I plan to enhance this further. And yeah, what I really think is this one. This one. What I really think is, once you get so far to this your first game step, you can really stop just reading on in the docs and start programming. And of course, there will be a lot of things that you don't know how to do, but this is the point where YouTube tutorials come in. That's my mobile phone. Let me put it away. So if you know, we will probably not know for a lot of things how to do them, but it's also a little bit where the fun of programming comes from, I think. So you can always, from what you learned in the scripting step, just think about how you could do it, and if you don't figure it out, you can always just Google it. For example, let's say we want to find out how to do a pathfinding algorithm in Godot. And here you go. There are some YouTube tutorials, some text documentations, and you can really just choose any of them, and they will probably help you. And you might think this is cheating or something, but it's really not. It's how game development pretty much works. You just coding in general, programming in general. You just Google 50% of the things and make the other thing 50% of the things up yourself. And from that point, there are really not that many things you still have to do. And no, you might have to learn how problem solving works, how you can interpret error messages, although this is really not that hard. And I won't explain, this is not a tutorial in the classical, in the traditional sense. I try to explain to you how I learned Godot and how I think is a pretty good way to learn it. I'm not actually explaining how to do it, as you may have figured. But I really think it's not that hard. It's the whole Godot engine is pretty easy to understand. It's not that many things going on here other than in Unity, where there's text everywhere. It's pretty intuitive, I think, and you should really give it a try if you want to get into game development and not have that much experience before and don't already know something like C Sharp where Unity would probably be more fitting for you. So yeah, that's it for this video. I think I hope it was not that terrible. I'm trying to improve myself for future videos, but I will probably not re-record this because then I would just end up doing 1,000 attempts of this and never be good because I'm not really used to this.